plastic pollution may lead to new antibiotics that could kill superbugs. The global threat of plastic pollution is real, and one day, we may just be chowing down on plastics. Another unrelated global problem is antimicrobial resistance, which may kill humans one day. But a group of researchers has connected these two distant things, suggesting that plastic pollution may lead us to antibiotics meant for superbugs. According to the US CDC, antibiotic resistance occurs when germs defeat the drugs designed to kill them, called antibiotics. Your body isn't the one resistant to antibiotics, but the microbes involved. When a colony of bacteria survives a course of antibiotics, there's a chance that survivors will evolve and develop genes resistant to an antibiotic class. This is why you should never take antibiotics without a prescription, and why doctors should never prescribe one unless a bacterial infection is confirmed. In new research, antimicrobial resistance and plastic pollution managed to cross each other for odd reasons. A study led by researchers at Scripps Institute of Oceanography found that plastic pollution might show us how to create newer antibiotics. These new drugs could potentially kill the superbugs we face today. Although this research is still in its early stages, the team already discovered the signs. Here's how these two things crossed each other. Piles of plastic trash are good spots for disease-causing germs and other nasty microbes. They make excellent ecosystems for microscopic living things. When the microbial biomass stabilizes, it becomes a candidate for antibiotic production and more. For those who don't know, antibiotics aren't always derived from synthetic items. When they were first discovered, scientists produced antibiotics using germs. The once unbeatable penicillin was originally collected from penicillium molds or fungi. There's also the Streptomyces genus of bacteria that led to antibiotics streptomycin and tetracycline, antifungals natamycin and nystatin, and many antiparasitics. The team detected a potential in the platysphere using the tiny Earth citizen science approach by Dr. Joe Handelsman. They modified it to work on marine conditions. They incubated common grocery bags made of high and low density polyethylene plastic in the water near Scripps Pier for 90 days. They were able to isolate 5 antibiotic-producing bacteria from ocean plastic. These included Bacillus, Phyobacter, and Vibrio, which were tested against many gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria. The isolates successfully fought 2 antibiotic-resistant strains. Considering the current antibiotic crisis and the rise of superbugs, it is essential to look for alternative sources of novel antibiotics, said study lead author Andrea Price of National University for SciTech Daily. The team presented their research at the American Society for Microbiology conference in Washington, D.C. Do you believe that plastic junk may let us produce new antibiotics? What else do you think? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.